Hey guys, it's Vicky. So I was watching Michelle1218's video on the Revlon lip butters, and it kind of inspired me to do this video. So I do want to talk about lip products, and mainly it's the lip butters, but I have one product in here that's not a lip butter. So that's why I can't really name the tutorial just the lip butters. The review or whatever, the video on that. What it inspired me to think about was basically why or what makes a lip butter or any kind of lip product something that people rave about, that are like, oh my God, I need to go get 50 million more of these, or, you know, whatever hype that surrounds any kind of product. So I went through my lip butters. Now, I don't have a million lip butters. I am not like, you know, a major connoisseur of them or anything like that, but I do have some that I think are worth mentioning and kind of putting them up to a battle against each other, I think, or it's worth it. Not that I can't use like every product, because you can use like a million and one in a day. Like, I can't tell you that I wear the exact same lipstick all day long, because I may walk out the door with one lipstick and then I end up applying a lip butter and then I end up applying a lipstick again and then just chapstick. So it changes all day for me. So I'm all for all different kinds of lip butter products, but I wanted to mention like the different kinds that are there and what I use and how I like to use them. So, first one, of course, I will mention the Revlon lip butters. Now, these are kind of hard to find, and I happened to find one by like dumb luck, and I was at a CVS, and I was literally walking out with like all this stuff in my hands, and there was like a little display case, and I swear there was like 15 little slots to have these like sitting in, and there was like three left. So, of course, total impulse buy, total like, oh, I've heard about them on YouTube, not needing that. And the one that I did pick up is the Berry Smoothie, the lip butter. Now, everyone's talked about the case and how it's like in this little sheer case. The color of this is really pretty. I have it on my lips right now. It is definitely a berry color. I'll swatch it on my hand for you. So, whoops. That's what it looks like. I like this product a lot. Now, I don't know, maybe it's my lips, or maybe like I need to drink more water, but even as I'm talking to you, my lips happen to catch each other, like kind of catching them. And that's one thing that bothers me just like a little bit about this. I love the fact that it's glossy. I love the fact that you get color. And I love the fact that it's lip butter. But I have had this for a week and a half. And I've been using it every day. Maybe not, if not every day, then every other day. And on my lips, for whatever reason, it gets that, or it doesn't feel super hydrated. So I love this product, but I kind of find myself putting a chapstick first. So I put my EOS on and then I put this on, and then it works great. I don't know that I'm going to go and get all of them, to be honest with you. And maybe I'm crazy. Maybe like I really need to be giving this a more of a chance. But it's like I'm not head over for this one for some reason. I do have other lip butters that I like a little bit more, that are a little bit more moisturizing, but they're not in this way. So this is great because it's like a lipstick, you know, and it looks really pretty. The packaging is really pretty, and you can apply it like a lipstick. In the little pots, yeah, the downfall is you have to put your finger in there, and Lord knows we touch a million gross things throughout the day. And this works great. It really does. It was, I think, like $6.79 or like $7, between $7 and $8 for this. And, I don't know that I would go out and buy like five more of these. Like, I think they're great, and I don't know that I would. And I think it's just, maybe it's me. Like, maybe it's my lips, or I don't know, maybe I'm like a weirdo. I don't know what's wrong with me, because everyone else is hyping about them. Ones that I really do love, and now I found out that they do come in a form where you don't have to put your finger in it, is the Korres, or the Korres lip butters. Kind of awkward for me to hold these up. But I've had these for a long time, and I gotta say, I really like the formula in these. And now that they come in like a tube, I think I would actually rather buy one of these than the Revlon one. I don't know. I think it's honestly, it's just a personal preference. I really do. My all-time favorite one by Korres is the Jasmine one. This for sure, hands down, is like my go-to. I have this on a lot of the time. I've used a good amount of it, and the smell of it is like, I don't know, it's weird. It's like a plastic doll, it reminds me of. I know that's weird, but it reminds me of a plastic doll. I feel like, yeah, it is gross. You have to use your finger, and I have the Revlon on, but when I put that on, I just feel like it's a little less sticky. I don't know why I get a little bit of the sticky with the Revlon one. Again, I'm like not knocking if you love them and you went and got all of them. That is not what I'm doing. I'm just saying, for me personally, if there's anybody else out there on the planet that they make their lipstick, that's what I'm saying. The other colors that I have by Korres is the pomegranate color. This does definitely put a little color on your pout. It's something I don't use as often. As you can see, I have a little bit more in this one. Again, it's gross because you have to put your finger in there, and I know that is so gross, but I do have to purchase the ones in the tube because I really like this formula. It doesn't do the sticky thing on my lip. And then the last one, which is one I reach for a little bit more now, is the Korres Wild Rose. And this one does put a good amount of color on your lip. It is a super berry color, and I haven't used a lot of it, as you can see, but because I kind of forget about this. This is with me in my bag a lot, but I have it in one of these cute little cases. I think I got it in like a Sephora, I don't know, some kind of deal that I got. And so I do carry these with me almost all the time, but I kind of do forget about them. And now, like, the kind of the lip butter craze, like the Revlon thing, I kind of rethought about them. So I do like this product. I'm not saying I hate it. I do like it, but I like these a little better. I love that this is in a tube, like a lipstick tube. The fact that these are in a tube formula as well, I really kind of am leaning more towards these to purchase over this one. But like for a drugstore, if you didn't want to go to the Korres, because these get pricey. I forget how much I paid for this, but these are pricey. I think this is a great route. Now, excuse me, another alternative to like that, it's not like a lip balm or lip butter, but the Tarte's Lip Surgeon's Natural Lip Tint. And I have the color Moody, and this is like a cute little one that I got. Like, I didn't get all the colors, but I really like these a lot too. Like, this is a really great product. It gives you a little mint tingle on your lip, and the color is really good. I'll swatch it on my hand so you can kind of see what it looks like. And even though it's not a lip butter, it kind of acts like one a little bit. I have to say that, like, because it's moisturizing, it has a little bit of the gloss to it. It gives you a little color, the little beeping if you hear it. That's Hank. He likes to do that when I do videos. But these are great too. So if you don't want to do the butter craze, or you don't want to do, you know, like the Revlon or the Korres, but you do have Tarte, I haven't tried the Clinique Chubby Stick yet, but I'm super excited to try that out because I think those are really cute too. They come in a whole array of colors, and I think they kind of do the same thing. But they don't make my lips stick. And for some reason, my Revlon, I so want to love this, but I don't know why it makes my like lips stick. And I don't like that. I hate that it does that. So, when I get my hands on one of the Clinique Chubby Sticks, I'll definitely let you know what I think of it. And I feel really bad. Like, I feel I should really like it, but I don't love it. So that's my thoughts. Purely, you can hate on me, whatever you need to do, but thank you for watching if you're still watching. Bye.